Welcome back to Prions on Catalyst University. My name is Kevin Tokoph. Please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel for future videos and notifications. In this video, we're going to discuss a prion disease called variant Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, also called mad cow disease. Now, most likely in the news, probably in the last 20 years or so, you've probably heard of mad cow disease. So mad cow disease, I want to make a distinction at the beginning of this video. Mad cow disease is a prion disease in cows. Okay? However, this disease, if you were to consume cattle meat that is tainted with mad cow disease, this disease can be transmitted to humans. And when this disease arises in humans, it gets a new term, technically, variant Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. All right, so in the past couple of videos, the first one we talked about classical Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. This was the form of CJD in which it arose due to an intrinsic misfolding of the prion protein into its infectious form denoted PRPSC. And here's the aggregations of that infectious protein over here on the far right. So the key here is this is really just a sporadic misfolding, a spontaneous misfolding, intrinsic to the person. It does not require the consumption of any extraneous or exogenous form of the protein. Okay? Now, in the case of kuru, this was a disease caused by eating the brains of someone affected with classical Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. So this is not an intrinsic misfolding. This is actually, you're actually directly consuming either this prion protein right here that's misfolded or its aggregates. And then that disease is then transmittable to future generations of people that actually eat that brain. Now, again, most people don't eat brains of people, but this has actually been, it's mostly been eradicated by education, but it has been it originated actually on this island in the oceanic area north of Australia called Papua New Guinea. There were indigenous tribes here that actually performed cannibalism on deceased people's brains who actually were affected with Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, that is the classical form. And they ended up developing kuru as a result. And really, kuru is just the form of classical Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease that arises because you ate the brain. So it has to arise from an exogenous source. What we're going to see in this video is that variant Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease is actually very, very similar in mechanism to kuru, except for the fact that it doesn't require you to eat a human brain. It requires that you eat a cow that's affected with a very similar disease. So here's a cow. This is a cow with what we call bovine spongiform encephalopathy. This is the scientific name, I guess you could say, for mad cow disease. On the news, you hear about it as mad cow disease. And really with these cattle, they have several distinct features that give away that they have mad cow disease. One, they have noticeable weight loss. They're going to have weight loss. They're also going to have postural problems. This cow is actually not having a very good posture. He's having to compensate a little bit. And eventually they'll get to a point where they can't stand up and they'll just have to lay down for basically the rest of their lives. And really, you are not supposed to consume or sell this kind of meat. You're actually supposed to kill the cow and basically burn it because no one can eat this. And the reason they have this bovine spongiform encephalopathy, which we'll come back to in a minute, is because they have a misfolded form of the prion protein. Very similar to what happened in the video on classical Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease. Imagine that now we're not talking about a human, now we're talking about a cow. It's exactly the same as this, except it's the cow form of it. They have a prion protein, PRPC. In the cow, it misfolds, and they develop prion protein SC. Okay, so they have now the infectious form of this prion protein, and it can aggregate like this. Okay, and that will cause bovine spongiform encephalopathy. There is another way the cows can get it. In the past in Europe, they fed the cows bone meal from previously deceased cows. And if that cow had classical CJD, then because this protein is infectious, the cow that consumes that bone meal could then develop mad cow disease. Okay, but mad cow disease is really just going to have the same underlying mechanism for the most part as classical Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, except it's in cow. And so they've got these aggregates of this prion protein SC, the infectious form of the prion. Now, if you sacrifice this cow, butchered it, slaughtered it, etc., sold the meat, and you consumed it. Okay, we're going to find a similar thing to the kuru, except this is mad cow disease. So you're going to consume this cattle meat. You are actually going to consume this aggregation of the infectious prion protein. It's going to wind up in your GI. This is the consumer's GI. But remember, this aggregate of prion proteins is incredibly resistant to proteolytic hydrolysis in both the GI and the stomach. So it's protease resistant, so it more or less survives. And when it gets absorbed into the blood, which it can be, it'll travel to the brain. And now this aggregate of proteins is going to be in the consumer's brain. It can end up inside neurons, where it will continue to aggregate, propagate in a chain reaction-like fashion, to where you'll get a bunch now, a bunch of these aggregates of proteins. And again, there's a lot of different ways that they disrupt the brain and cause cell death. One of the ways they do it is by disrupting calcium homeostasis. These prion proteins can actually insert themselves into the membranes of cells, allowing excessive calcium influx, which disrupts mitochondrial function and ultimately promotes apoptosis. The cells just become extremely stressed and they die. And so what you have here is, this is actually why these are called spongiform encephalopathies. In fact, classical Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, kuru, and this variant form of CJD, these are all spongiform encephalopathies because notice that when these areas which are darker where the cells actually die, you can actually see that it sort of takes on a Swiss cheese or a sponge-like appearance. You get these nasty lesions where the cells are dying. And so because it looks like a sponge, a kitchen sponge, they call it a spongiform encephalopathy because the brain looks like a sponge. Okay, that's actually where it gets its name from. In fact, there's direct evidence that this is due to prions because here they actually stained the prion proteins in a brown color, and you can actually see lots of aggregation of these prion proteins around these neurons. Okay, so in any case, what's going to happen is when you get enough of these cells dying, there's going to be a noticeable change in the individual. Again, this condition is not curable. There is no way to reverse it. It is fatal in 100% of cases. Initially, what you'll notice is there will be symptoms very similar to both classical CJD and kuru, such as memory problems. But one of the big things that's noticeable in the early stages of variant CJD is you'll have behavioral changes. So a lot of times the people will start acting crazy. That's one of the things. But they'll also develop weakness, poor coordination in a similar manner to the mad cow disease, which is the form of this in cows. Okay. So, but eventually over time, it will lead to death of the individual. Okay. And so 100% of cases, this is fatal. Now, even though there has been a lot of negative talk about mad cow disease, and certainly it is negative, just because you actually consume a cow that had mad cow disease does not actually guarantee you're going to get variant CJD. The major reason for this is actually the entire body of the cow is not equal in its distribution of the prion protein. Okay? The prion protein is going to be most concentrated in the central nervous system. And generally when you eat parts of a cow, you're consuming more or less in the torso area. That's like if you eat a ribeye steak, a sirloin, it's going to be in the torso area. I'm not an expert on where the meat comes from which parts of the cow. But in any case, you would really have to, if you wanted to guarantee 100% that you get variant CJD, you'd have to eat the brain of the cow. So there's not a 100% transmission rate with this, okay? The transmission rate is nowhere near what it is for kuru, and the reason it isn't is because with kuru, you're directly eating the brain. I say you rhetorically, but these people are directly eating the brain. So, of course, they're actually going to get it transmitted. With mad cow disease, it's not a 100% thing. You would have to actually consume this prion protein in an area of the cow where it happened to have a high enough concentration of this aggregated protein. And mostly that's going to be in places that are rich with neurons, such as the brain, which most people are not going to consume a cow brain. But unfortunately, if you do happen to consume enough of this, it will unfortunately lead to the death of neurons in your brain, and it is ultimately fatal. So hopefully in this video, you learned a little bit of something about mad cow disease, how it leads to, or can lead to, I should say, variant Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease, how it's not 100% and there is a difference between these two. Mad cow disease is the form of this in cows, but variant Creutzfeldt-Jakob disease is the form of it in humans that's transmittable from cows. All right, please make sure to like this video and subscribe to my channel for future videos and notifications. Thank you.